So hello learners, welcome again to Manifested E-Learning Platform. And today we are going to continue with the taxation of advanced aspect of business income. Taxation of advanced aspect of business income. As we said there before during introduction, we said that here we consider the taxation of those specialized entities which were not covered in the previous level of taxation or public finance. So I would like us to continue with the topic, with the subtopic, that is a conversion of a partnership to limited liability companies, to limited liability companies and change. So in this particular case, we will see how partnerships are converted to a limited liability company. We will also see, for instance, if there is a change in partnership, like admission of a new partner or retirement of a partner. The basics of partnerships was covered in the other level. But during this particular class, maybe we can take a recap of what we covered maybe in the other level. So we can ask ourselves, what is a partnership? A partnership simply means an association of persons who have come together, combined their resources in order to do business, maybe with a view of making a profit. And partnerships, they are formed by a minimum of two persons and maybe a maximum of like 20 partners. Therefore, the moment the partnership is formed, so we need to come up with a way of managing that particular partnership. And therefore, that is done through a partnership deed. In our concern here, we need to understand now how those particular partnerships are supposed to be taxed. So we need to know the statements that are supposed to be prepared and how the tax liability is supposed to be calculated. In partnerships, the normal taxable incomes of business, they are normally they are captured. For instance, sales generated by the partnerships, we can have taxable incomes, and this will include like the sales made in partnership. So if they are buying and selling goods, the sales that they make, those incomes are supposed to be subjected to tax. Then again, we have like a discount received. Discount received is also taxable. It should be subjected to tax. Again, we have decrease in specific provision for bad debts. For decrease in specific for bad debts, that again should be treated as a taxable income. Again, we have another taxable income, that is specific bad debts recovered. So again, if we have such an income, it should be subjected to tax accordingly. The other income that is taxable is realized foreign exchange gains. Realized foreign exchange gains. Again, if the partnership earns that particular income, it is supposed also to be subjected to tax. We also have another income, that is trading receipt. Trading receipt is a profit that is realized if you dispose assets of a certain class belonging to a given class of year and tier at a price higher than the written down value, and that particular business is continuing. So that profit that you get is also taxable. We include it. The other taxable income is balancing charge. This is also considered as a taxable income. A rebalancing charge means that income that is realized, profit that is realized, if you sell assets of a given class of wear and tear at a price higher than the written down value, and that particular business is closing down. So that profit is also taxable. So trading receipt and balancing charge, they are similar, only that this is when the business is continuing and this is when the business is closing down. Then the other major taxable income that we include is investment incomes. Investment incomes. And this includes like dividends, we have interest, we have rental income, we have farming income. So all those incomes that are generated again by the partnership, they are supposed to be subjected to tax or be included as part of taxable incomes. We can also highlight some of the allowable expenses. Allowable expenses. Under some of the allowable expenses of the partnership, they include like a specific bond debts. They are allowable. We have specific provision for bond debts. Specific provision for bond debts, they are also allowable. We have realized foreign exchange loss. Realized foreign exchange loss. That is also treated as an allowable cost. We also have trading loss. We also have balancing deductions. Balancing deductions are similar to trading receipt and balancing charge. But if you get a loss, you sell assets for a certain class and you get a loss. That loss is, if the business is continuing, is referred to as trading loss. And if the business is closing down, that loss is known as balancing deduction. We also have other allowable costs like revenue expenses, e.g. salaries, electricity, water, rent, all that. In other words, all expenses incurred by the partnership in the process of generating that particular taxable income, those revenue expenses, they are also deductible. Last but not least, we have also capital allowances. And capital allowances are those particular costs, that deduction that is made if the partnership has bought some assets and these assets are used in the generation of taxable income. So that capital allowance that loss of value should be deducted and be also treated as allowable cost. In partnership also, I can highlight some of the like non-taxable incomes. Eh? We have taxable incomes, we have also non-taxable incomes. So some of the non-taxable incomes, which are also applicable to all forms of business enterprises, not only partnership. These non-taxable incomes include, for instance, unrealized foreign exchange gains. So if foreign exchange gain is realized, it is taxable. If it is not realized, that income is not taxable. The other non-taxable income is a decrease in general provision for bad debts. Decrease in general provision for bad debts. So if somebody makes the provision for bad debts for the first time, it is treated as an expense, and that expense is not allowable. But then next year, you're supposed to make another provision. So if it reduces, then that is termed as a decrease in general provision for bad debts, and it is treated as a non-taxable income. The other non-taxable income is general, band, debts, recovered. General bad debts recovered. General bad debts recovered. Again, we treat them also as non-taxable income. We also have other non-taxable incomes, like for instance, dividends and interest from outside Kenya. So if you get dividends or interest from outside the country, that income again is treated as tax exempt, or it is not taxable. So these are some of the non-taxable incomes again that we have.